Sorry, I've started already. Hello, everyone, ladies and germlings, boys and girls, and welcome to Bit of Beer Goggles Reviews with yours truly, Terry, doing this thing and that, you know. We've got one here. I'm such a pleb, you know. Not here, I've got one here. I've got one here. Like Van Gogh had one here, didn't he? He never put his sunglasses on, probably. But anyway, I'm sorry, I've gone off now. I've gone off on one, you know. Pride and Joy. Pride and Joy. In my pride and joy. Where'd that come from? Just got a fruit fly. A fruit fly's come out of nowhere in this weather, didn't I? Right, I've just been down to Vocation Brewery. Up to North and all that business. And Hebden Bridge. And in West Yorkshire, I believe, and it was lovely. I'd kind of right near. I've been amongst all the Bronte country and everything, and I went on the railway down there, the Haworth to Keighley, is it? Keighley, I should say. Railway and stuff. Poof, puff, 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 where the Railway Children was filmed, and Peaky Blinders was filmed. A great train robbery, and trouble with me arse, didn't I? Me arse, got ya. I caught the little sod. Ping. There he is, right up and down me trousers. Ugh, get off, right. Sorry, talk amongst yourselves. This is why I sit here killing animals. Sorry, I didn't kill him. I sprayed him with starch. He just glided out the window. It's kind, isn't it? Stop it. Yes, Vocation Brewery. And so we've got Pride and Joy. Pride and Joy. Sorry, I've gone off a little bit of Stevie Ray Vaughan there, I was. And that's what the label looks like. Kind of proper, like, down there with, you know, damn with the kids and that, yeah, and all that. Is it like that? Yeah, that's on the phone, that is. It's like, I always think they're playing, you know, rock, paper, scissors. It's like, okay, you win. Sorry, I've gone off on one. And photos, what is it with photos nowadays? Every single kid you see on the thing. So it look like dirty bastards, like, like duck lips, I think they call it.
What was your dream, boy?
What was it? Used to have, was it Benny Hill? No, it was Les Dawson when it used to have. Look at my turkey neck. Look, Les Dawson used to have a character, Cosmo Smallpush.
Oh, you damn, I like knockers.
Sorry, I've gone off in I've gone off a lot on kind of a meandering route. Get on with it. Pride and Joy, and this is an American Pale Ale. 5.3. It's going to have a big hot presence because all their stuff has, but they are all different and they're all delicious and nutritious and fantastic. And sexy and everything. That is lovely. It looks sexy already. There's the carbonation and all that punching and perking. Nice little head on it. Little northern little head. So it's a northern head. It's doing its own thing. And let's have a little spin and see what's in. Pardon, don't know it. Oh. Nice little kind of lemony notes in there. You've got nice little kind of kumquats and things like kumquats. Fizzlist. apart from those that no one knows what the bloody hell I'm on about, you know, it's like, what, tell we don't eat them little things. You've got to try different things, you know. Sharon fruits and physalis and things like that. All interesting little flavours. Some ain't worth it. I had a great big, what was it, pompanella thing or something. Great big thing that's like a massive big grapefruit, and it tasted just like a grapefruit. It's like, I paid like £2 for this, or whatever it was. Anyway, I do divulge. Bits of pineapple. A little bit more subdued on the bugle. Not quite as hop as the other ones were. But then I don't suppose it's supposed to be, you know. A bit more balanced. Lovely notes though, you know, really lovely. Little kind of a slight bitter and earthy note in there as well. Little cascadey little orangey notes and that. Slight hints of dried fruit, but kind of a dried, like dried blackberry or something like that. But little hints of it, you know. It almost, you can almost get that, you know, the kind of little earthy notes off of the top and skin and things like that. And the malts are showing in this one, which is really nice. You know, it's nice to go get a little bit of biscuity malts and that showing off. Right, let's have a little taste. Cheers. Oh, that is lovely. Pride and Joy. It's an American pale ale, I'll say. And the hops are in there. They're like, yeah, like that. But they're in there with a nice little sweetness all going around. It's kind of like, you know, if you have a toffee apple or something, you know, the apple is like, it's apple. But the toffee around it makes it all the better, you know. And the same with, like, lemonade and things. If you have lemonade without a ton of... If you just make lemons and water and all that, boil them up together and things, you know, you, without loads and loads of sugar in, it's going to be horrible. And they're like, as soon as you put a load of sugar in, it changes the profile completely. And it's not... this the malty sort of sweetness in there coming in and really just blending in really beautifully. And this is... what I would call a perfect session beer. 5.3 ABV. Nice session. You know, 5.3 as a session beer, if it ain't massively hoppy. With something like the, where was it, Heart and Soul. It's called a session IPA. 4.4, that will get you as kind of drunk as quickly as a 5.3 with less hops in it. Because the hops kind of relax everything and make it a bit more susceptible to the alcohol. So, you know, the Pride and Joy, it kind of balances up. And it's one of those beers you really could session this. With the Heart and Soul, it's, you know, lovely. You could really session it, but it would kind of, it's strong. It's a challenge almost, you know. Whereas this one is just, you drink it, oh, you're going to drink more. And it's going to be dangerous almost at 5.3. It's going to go, come on, get another one down. Would really go nice with food as well. Just lovely. I could imagine a bit of oily fish and chips with that or something. And then just get some of that and you go, oh, that's nice. Give us some more. Eating it with your fingers. Sorry, but there you go. And that is Pride and Joy. That is really a lovely, lovely, lovely beer. Just makes you relax. You know, the other one's like, I'm like that with. And this one's just like, oh, just relax. I can imagine being in the back garden after mowing the lawn or something, just sitting there in the sun, getting one or two of these down you. Lovely. Absolutely lovely. What do I reckon? Bam, 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 bam. Lovely. Try it, buy it, and love it. Try it, buy it, and make love to it as well. See you in the next one. Take care. Don't be late, or I will start without you. Mmm. Oh, it's so easy to drink. Bye.